on after 8 o'clock.
610 CKTB on the Tim Dennis program. We were talking last week about going tobogganing. We finally got some snow. So people wanted to go tobogganing, and then there was the story from the falls of people who wanted to go tobogganing at Fireman's Park, and there were signs up saying you couldn't. Not that they were warning you that you were doing it at your own risk. They actually said, don't. You can't do this. And they were closing off part of the park. And, of course, this got people into this discussion about what, you know, what is this all about? There were a lot of texts to the program talking about, oh, they just want to outlaw fun. You know, we did this as kids, and we got away with it, and we all grew up. But the bigger issue here is that people like the city of Niagara Falls or the city of St. Catharines or others could be sued, just like the firemen are being sued because somebody had an accident in that park tobogganing. So there are bigger issues here. Brian Cameron, a lawyer with Oatley Vigmond, is here to talk about the mixed messages this all sends. Brian, good to talk to you.
Good morning, Tim. Thanks for having me.
When a group is being sued because of something that happened on their property, I suppose it's understandable that they would want to make sure that doesn't happen again. So when you put up a sign telling people you can't toboggan here, does that absolve you of responsibility?
No, it really doesn't. I mean, it could, and it would certainly make it much harder for someone to bring an action, but it doesn't immediately make it that there's not going to be any liability. It would depend on the specific circumstances. But what I think people have to keep in mind with these bans, I think it's quite an overreaction, because anytime you do sue someone, it's not a matter of I was hurt on your property and therefore you're liable for what happens to me. You do have to prove that there was something inherently dangerous with the property. For example, a ski hill that maybe, you know, ended on a busy street, or not a ski hill, but a tobogganing hill, or there's, you know, hidden obstructions under the snow, you know, posts or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not so simple as, well, you're skiing on this hill and you were hurt, because tobogganing can be, it's a fun activity, largely safe, but people can get injured, like with skiing, skating, you know, anything along those lines. You could suffer an injury, but if there's nothing wrong with the hill and nobody from the city or the fire department did anything wrong, they're just simply not going to be liable.
The same can be said if you're skating on a pond and if the ice isn't thick enough, that's not necessarily the city's fault, is it?
Well, no, it's not the city's fault at all. I mean, if somebody goes through some ice on a pond and it's not thick enough, that's the weather. There's no negligence there. There's nothing to say to the city, well, you should have done this, because that's basically the question you have to answer if you think about it in very simple terms. If somebody's negligent, well, what should they have done to make it safe? Is it reasonable? So with thin ice, what should the city have done? Made it colder? I mean, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
And sometimes even putting out, if they start to put out signs and saying, don't do it, well, then the one place they forget to do it might be negligent in that you didn't warn me. That's going to be the cause of action. So in some ways, putting up these signs in some places might make it easier for somebody to sue in the one place you didn't put up a sign.
What do you do if you're a city or somebody that, you know, runs a park? Having said all of that, with all of the this litigious society of ours, as we refer to it these days, do you do anything? Do you do your due diligence by just putting up a sign saying, look, you're at your own risk here? Does that cover you?
Well, that's a good start. Or you put up a sign, for example, the ice may be thin. You could put up a sign that say, you know, of any potential warnings, or that you use it at your own risk. I mean, those signs can be effective as a defense in litigation, because it's very hard for a plaintiff to argue that they didn't know there was a problem when there was a big sign right there. You see it in ski cases all the time. I mean, they have some very effective waivers now. When you go skiing at Blue Mountain, for example, it's on the tickets, it's posted all around, but nobody would seriously consider saying, well, we're not going to have skiing anymore. But, you know, a lot of people get injured fairly seriously skiing. Nobody ever talks about, well, let's get rid of skiing. I don't know why they're doing it with something like tobogganing and skating that people have been doing in this country for hundreds of years.
I mean, there isn't anything that has changed, has there, Brian, in terms of law in the last little while that has increased a municipality or a park's likelihood of being sued? There's nothing that's different, is there?
No, there's not really anything that's different, but what happens a lot of the time, there's a couple of factors. If there's ever a big judgment against a municipality for doing something wrong, then people tend to get more aware and start to take what I believe is are somewhat overreactions in this case. And then there's also the reality is the insurance industry and industries like that want the public to think we are in a litigious society, and they tend to publish the more marginal cases, and they want it to get press because it ultimately helps them in the courtroom. Because the reality is we're not in that litigious of a society. You know, people are not suing over the drop of a hat. In a case like the tobogganing case, minor little injuries probably happen all the time, sprained ankles, things like that. Nobody sues over that. I mean, they might, if somebody is rendered a quadriplegic, somebody may take a good look at it. But, you know, beyond serious injuries, you know, this litigation just isn't happening.
Brian, a pleasure to talk to you. Thanks for enlightening. That's a good chat. Thanks.
Thanks very much. You have a nice day.
Brian Cameron is a lawyer with Oatley Vigmond, and there you have it. It's happening and continues to happen. If you've got some thoughts, you can certainly let us know. And our text address is 610-10.